Next continuation. Let the surface encloses a volume V. Now the whole volume may be assumed to be divided into a very large number of cubical volume elements are joined to each other. Consider a small cubical volume element We know that divergence A represents the amount of flux diverging per unit volume and hence the flux diverging from the element of volume V or dV, here we take small volume, will be divergence A into dV. So here let the surface encloses a volume V. Now the whole volume may be assumed to be divided into a very large number of cubical volume elements adjoined to each other. In this, consider a small cubical volume element. We know that divergence A represents the amount of flux diverging per unit volume, and hence the flux diverging from the element of volume dV will be divergence dV. That can be written as volume integration divergence A into dV. After that, consider a small element of area ds on the surface S. And here, n-cap represents unit vector with normal to area ds. If the field vector A bar and outward normal n bar are at angle T, theta, the component of capital A bar along n cap, we can write A cos theta equal to A dot n cap. Now we consider, a small element of area ds on the surface S, let n bar or let n cap represents the unit vector drawn normal to area ds. It should be remembered that outward drawn normal on a surface is taken as positive if the field vector A bar and outward normal n cap are at an angle theta then the component of A bar and along n cap is A cos theta equal to A dot n cap. So here consider a small element of area ds on the surface S. Let n cap represent the unit vector drawn normal to area ds. It should be remembered that outward drawn normal on a surface is taken as positive. If the field vector A bar and outward normal n cap are at an angle theta, then the component of A bar along n cap, we can write A cos theta equal to A dot n cap. Next, the flux of A bar through the surface element ds is given by a dot n cap into ds equal to a dot ds. Here the flux of a bar through the surface element ds is given by a dot n cap into ds equal to a dot ds. And the total flux, the total flux through the entire surface S is given by surface integration a dot ds. So this must be equal to flux diverging from the whole volume V enclosed by the surface S. Hence, we can write surface integration equal to volume integration. So this must equal to the total flux diverging from the whole volume V enclosed by the surface S. So from above equations we can write surface integration a dot ds equal to volume integration divergence a bar into dv. So this is the Gauss theorem of divergence. This is Gauss theorem of divergence. So from this we can say that surface integration equal to volume integration. That means double integration equal to volume integration. So this Gauss theorem, may also be written as surface integration a dot n cap into ds equal to volume integration del dot a into dv. So this is the Gauss divergence theorem after Green's theorem. So Green's theorem statement is, if pi comma xi are two scalar point functions such that these functions and their first derivatives are continuously differentiable in a region bounded by a closed surface, then we have two equations. We have two equations after proof of Green's theorem. Stokes' theorem. Next, Gauss divergence theorem are after Green's theorem.